Hello and welcome to my reaction to episode 4 of Tokyo Magnitude 8.0 or 8.0, I don't know, it's better pronounced. Episode 3, they're on a boat and people died, and I guess the kids started to trust Mari a bit more. And yeah, that's about everything that really is worth mentioning, I would say. It's a very moment-to-moment show. There's no plot line, it's just watching those characters survive. Maybe not the most reacting worthy show, but yeah, I'm enjoying it, I don't care. Episode 4, let's get into this in 3, 2, 1. I'm repeating myself, but once again, we thought that a rock song was a good choice for the opening of a like earthquake natural disaster survival show. We thought that was a good idea. It sounds like a shonen anime opening, I mean, yeah. Oh yeah, the bridge collapsed and people died. Toilet or just some regular stomachache? A promise by the tree. Okay. Oh, she's just hungry. Okay. She's saying it again. There's some tree. There's some leaf if you need it. Yeah. Clearly. Especially after something like that, come on. I mean, actually, I guess if their house is fine, maybe they can go to a vacation. Of course, it's instant ramen, what else? Well, the park looks pretty safe. There's no big building next to it. Promised by the tree. Are they going to get separated again? Of course they are. Of course there is a line. That kind of fucking asshole. The classic. Don't ask a kid to back you up. Yeah. At least it opens someplace in the line. Oh, but she's scared. I can only imagine the relieving feeling she's got, yeah. Kind of a weird thing to give, chocolate, but okay. The fuck? No apologies. Bitch deserve to get slapped. Holy shit. I mean, this show we like to portray some people as pure assholes. Like, come on. Last episode they were bumping into a kid. Okay, maybe. Oh my god. I mean, it's your fault, so. Okay. This is really funny now. Okay, I say that as there's dead bodies. Timing. I was expecting her to get, like, as I said, in the toilet, them to get separated, but I guess it didn't happen. Goodness. Once again, it's a full of tension situation, so it's understandable, but she's still being a bitch. Each time they separate like that, I'm sure there's gonna be another quake and they're gonna actually get separated again. Can't help it. Understandable once again. I saw that coming. I was going to say, don't slap it out of his hand or something. Definitely wasn't the thing to say. I mean, he's a really nice kid. He hasn't been annoyed at all compared to her. First episode, I thought I was going to like her, but she's been so fucking bitchy. I'd say it. Justifiably so. To an extent, but still. She's still being bitchy. And once again, he fucking ran off, and they're not gonna find him. And now she runs off. Haven't they learned their lesson? Holy shit. Oh, Tokyo Tower, shit. Okay, it's still standing. Seriously. Okay, she catched up to him, good. The tower is definitely falling down. What a nice kid, seriously. Usually the younger one is the insufferable one, the annoying one. I'm pretty sure fine. As I said, I expect the final episode to be the classic reunion, family reunion. Some good people for once, other than Marie. Well, a good cry isn't a bad thing. It's falling down. Of course it's falling down onto them. Of course. Don't run. The classic running straight up when it's falling onto you. Separated again, of course. Who's that? Ah, shit. Got it. is hurt but is not dead. Hopefully this time they understood the fucking lesson. Stay together. Okay, Mary was very patient with them after they run away like that again after learning the lesson already. I know if it was me, I would have been quite mad. I would have been like, you fucking dumbass children, haven't you learned the lesson? Well, I guess she's a mom, so she's used to dealing with kids, so she doesn't get mad that easily. Hopefully this time they've actually really learned it and they don't do it again. I mean, I wouldn't be shocked if the show find a reason to separate them again, but I hope they don't run off on their own, is what I mean. I hope they don't do that again. That was enough. Otherwise, good episode. There's really not much to commentate on. It's more reaction to what's happening. But enjoyable, nonetheless. I wonder if this is if there are other anime about natural disaster like that. Obviously there is like post-apocalyptic survival show and that kind of stuff. But straight up, let me look. On my anime list there is a recommendation page. Let me look it up. Yeah, no, they're recommending a bunch of show. But none of them are exactly the same. I mean, one of the top recommendations is Grave of the Fireflies. It's if you don't know it, definitely watch it. It's about World War II. So, yeah. Copelion, post-apocalyptic, but it's not like a... Yeah, none of the show recommended are the same. They're not realistic in the sense that they're not real life stuff. It's a post-apocalypse after some like science fiction shit happened. Anyway, good episode. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.